Let's begin by animating the book. Import or draw the outline of the book cover like so. Select the path of the book and click Add Pins in the DUIK plugin. This will create a series of nulls that control the position of each of the points on the book outline. Go ahead and animate the movement of the points to close the book. When happy with this animation, bake the path property of the book and remove all the null layers and the effects and expression on the book layer. Now let's extrudalize the book layer and animate the rotation of the book. Now let's create the page flip. Create the composition and draw a straight line with 8 to 10 segments. Then select the path property of the shape you just drew and again use DUIK and click Add Pins. Next, select all the nulls and click Auto Rig. This will rig the nulls with the Bezier IK rig. Go ahead and animate the page root and page curve so that they are staggered in their movement, creating the page bend as it flips over. Once happy with the animation, bake the path keyframes and remove the null layers, effects, and expressions from the page shape layer. Create a new composition called Pages and add the page composition to it. Duplicate it 10 to 12 times, add time remapping, and stagger it with a 5-frame sequence. Move the top copy of the page 50 to 60 pixels up on the Y-axis. Select all the duplicates and distribute them vertically using the Align panel. Animate the position of the pages so that when the top page flips over, it goes to the bottom of the stack. Go back to the page composition and extrudalize the page layer and add expressions to connect the extrudalizer controller of the page to that of the book. You need to connect the position properties and the orbit rotation properties so that when you animate the rotation of the book, the pages follow in step. Now let's create the edges of the page. We will use the front and back strokes to create two edges, and then we will use Vertex Parenting tool to create the outer edge. First, open up the page layer, go to the back group and open it up. In the transform properties of this group, remove the expression in the opacity property so that the back stroke will always be visible. To add the outer edge, let's click on the Vertex Parenting tool once, then deselect the first parent, and then click it again to create the second parent. Adjust the position of the second parent to back and move it to the last vertex. Move the first vertex parent to the last vertex position, so both are sitting on the outer corners of the page. Draw a path and call it outer edge. Go to the path property and add a create path expression that will draw a line between vertex parent 1 and vertex parent 2. Now let's create the text. To save on space when exporting the animation to Lottie, we will use a single line and a repeater. Essentially, the text is the same as the front of the page, just shorter and offset in its position. So let's use that to create our text while applying a trim path with an offset to make it shorter. Create another shape layer and parent the path property to that of the front path on the page layer. Then add a trim path and a repeater and adjust to make it look like lines of text. In the pages composition, we need to adjust the stacking order of the pages so that when they flip, they go to the bottom of the stack to show 3D overlap. Also, pay attention to the last frame of the page flipping animation, since it is retimed, and before we start the book animation, we will need to make sure that all the duplicates are on the same timeline, otherwise they will not rotate in sync with the book. To do that, once we set the offset keyframes of the page flip, we go and look at the actual timeline time, and then we set the time remapping keyframe to the actual time on all layers so that everything syncs. Moving on to the next step. In the book composition, we need to now create the mask that will hide the portion of the pages that would be covered by the book cover. First, let's make sure that the book animation starts after the time we just synced. Then, to make the masking process a little easier, let's duplicate the book layer and remove all shapes other than the front, and let's drag this duplicate above the pages pre-composition. Now, Let's go through the animation and adjust the mask as needed. Once satisfied, let's move on to the final step. We are going to map the artwork to the book cover. Go to the part of the composition where you can clearly see the front of the book. Click the Map Artwork button and select the face you want to map the artwork to. If doing a Lottie animation, pick the second option, Transform Effect Mapping, and if not, you can go with Corner Pin Mapping. Click Proceed. A pre-composition will be created. Open it and place your book cover artwork in it and adjust to fill the pre-comp. You can go through an additional step of optimizing each extrudalized layer. Select the layer or layers and click Optimize. This will reduce the size and increase performance of the final Lottie export. To export, disable glyphs, enable hidden layers, and don't forget to include the artwork in the JSON. And you're done.